Philippine president expects to receive a windfall of investment pledges from his trilateral summit with the U.S. and Japan. His visit to Washington comes as U.S. lawmakers file a bill proposing huge military financing for the Philippines. Katrina Domingo is in Washington with tonight's top story.
A historic and possibly one of the most momentous events in our history. This is how Philippine Ambassador to the United States Jose Manuel Romualdez described the trilateral summit of the Philippines, Japan, and the United States. While the three countries are expected to amplify their commitment to uphold the rule of law in the South China Sea, Tokyo and Washington are also expected to pour in at least $100 billion in investments in the Philippines to accelerate and surge high-quality infrastructure in several key sectors, including energy, maritime cooperation, technology, and cybersecurity.
We're talking about $100 billion in investments in the next 5 to 10 years, perhaps even 5 years would probably be more appropriate because of the fact that we have a lot of areas where we are putting ourselves. A lot of these investments are mostly, as I said, in the semiconductor industry, which is part of our digital infrastructure, which is also very important, and also in the area of energy. The more exciting part of the clean energy projects that we're trying to lure into the country is the small modular nuclear power plants. The president's quite excited specifically about a company that is going to be supplying these small nuclear power plants.
Romualdez says while some U.S. companies are looking to bring in small modular nuclear power plants, the Philippines is also expected to benefit from Japan's growing production of defense and security technologies.
Japan now will be producing quite a number of technological enhancements for defense. And obviously, because of our relationship with both Japan and the United States, we most likely will be getting some of that, or we will be either we will be buying it or we will be given an opportunity to be able to have it as part of our defense modernization. So that is where the major change is, that the cooperation is so strong that we can expect a lot of these types of enhancements on the economic sphere, but which also can include defense.
Despite this show of force from Manila, Tokyo, and Washington, Romualdez insists that the three allies are not looking to provoke any country.
We're not looking for any conflict with any country. In fact, we're reaching out to the ASEAN region. Again, it's a multilateral approach. This is the policy that the president has spelled out to all of us.
U.S. National Security Communications Advisor John Kirby says there is no reason for China to overreact to the multilateral strategies happening in the region, specifically the recent quadrilateral exercises involving the Philippines, Australia, Japan, and the United States.
This is about freedom of navigation. It's about adherence to international law. It's about proving the simple point that we and our allies will fly, sail, and operate wherever international law permits us to do. And it does in the South China Sea, and we did.
Romualdez says all these meetings and deals are rooted on the Philippines' desire to do one thing.
We know clearly what we want to do, which is to protect our territory and our sovereign rights. And so all of these things that we're doing is precisely in that direction. For so many years, the Filipino patience has been stretched to the limit. And we're now at the point where are we just going to sit and allow our and see our fishermen suffer? We just want to be given our right to be able to explore our own environment, our territory, the respect for international law.
Meanwhile, two U.S. senators on Wednesday introduced a bipartisan bill to provide Manila with $2.5 billion worth of aid to boost its defenses against Chinese aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Reuters reports the bill allots $500 million a year in foreign military financing grant assistance to the Philippines over the five fiscal years to 2029.
All of these projects and commitments are expected to be outlined in a joint vision statement that three leaders will release after the trilateral summit. Aside from this historic meeting, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is also expected to have a bilateral meeting with U.S. President Joe Biden and a separate meeting at the Pentagon with U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. The Filipino leader is also expected to meet with several U.S. investors to convince them to do more business in the Philippines, including several executives from tech giant Google. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News, Washington, D.C.